We're in northeastern Slovenia in a small community called Petišovci, and it's here where a UK company called Ascent Resources wanted to frack for gas.
Ascent came to this site that has been abandoned for years and that already had 170 wells with the intention to extract huge amounts of gas through fracking. But even during the test phase, you could already see the negative impacts where local residents have been telling us how grounds have been shaking, how huge flares and flames of methane were burning through the night.
Big noise, then trembled the earth. The sky was bright with 30 meters flame. So terrible. There is a refinery of gas. And here is my home.
This is your home?
There you can see, but this is my home.
What are you worried about?
We are worried about water, because so many dangerous substances.
Investor is called Ascent Resources. What's really weird is that they have been shifting their seat from one tax haven to the other, from British Virgin Islands to Malta. Now they're operating from London. And they also claim they have invested 50 million into the research of the project. However, it's not clear where the money came from and for what exactly it was spent. They have also been trying really hard to frame this as, this is not fracking. Nothing really bad is going into the land.
And they didn't include the people. You see that somebody lied to you. We are not lambs, sheep. We are people.
In 9 years of fighting fracking in Slovenia, we did everything we could. First, we organized a big round table to get the media and Slovenian people know what the fracking is all about. And then we made a protest in the local community. In this way, with all this effort of many, many people, we were able to stop them 3 times.
So the resistance started here in the local community, and in parallel, there was a campaign to ban fracking completely in Slovenia by law. Because of all the potential risks, the government demanded an environmental impact assessment. But during the procedure, Ascent put a lot of pressure on our environmental agency and even the minister himself. And now the investor is even threatening to sue the government simply because they wanted to check if the mega project has any potential negative impacts on the environment.
Ascent is threatening to sue Slovenia for 120 million euros in compensation. And it is using a parallel justice system for corporations, the so-called Energy Charter Treaty. This treaty gives companies like Ascent a lot of power to sue governments outside of their courts and to win so much more money than they could ever win in a national or European court. So Slovenia is actually at high risk of losing a lot of taxpayer money for wanting to protect the environment from the damaging effects of fracking.
I think the last act of Ascent somehow shows also the global situation of shady investments trying to create their own environment, their own legal system to still and continuously get rich from the public money.
I have a message to the Slovenian government, ban fracking, and I have a message to all governments. Learn from our experience and leave the Energy Charter Treaty now, because the ECT allows the fossil fuel industry to destroy our planet.